think I'd be.
Welcome back to Good Springs here at the truck. You'll notice that Veronica here.
Is it a dress?
I went through my channels as a courier and got her some kind of beaten up Brotherhood T-51B power armor. God, I hate the fact that she wears that stupid hood. Just to get her looking better, and honestly, I couldn't...
You're making me carry the heavy stuff, aren't you?
I couldn't do anything else. You'll notice that I also filled up on ammunition. And, there you are, dear. And I took a bunch of stuff from my courier's stashes and moved them over to the truck. Now, I realize that people are going to look at this and go, you're cheating, you're a big cheater. But I never said that this was going to be a straight playthrough. I'm interested in the story of the game. I'm interested in the stories that we create playing the game. I'm not necessarily interested in the scrounging survivalist resource management type of stuff. It's the story that's driving me more than anything. And with Punchy Fisterton here running in and punching everything and getting killed all the time, and this little fucking space ball getting killed all the time, I got tired of it. So I got in touch with a bunch of other couriers, so to speak, and had some T-51B power armor. And it is Brotherhood power armor, although I don't know if you can quite tell that. But nonetheless, I got it shipped in, so Veronica's happy. She's got her power armor, and I gotta get her fist. Oh, I gotta get her fist. But yes, I took a bunch of stuff, you know, and transferred it over to the truck. Just so that we would have stuff and things to do with said stuff and stuff like that. And like I said, it's the story that I'm interested in, not so much... Grenades and such, yes, okay. Grenades and mines, mods. Oh well. Always carry the shovel with you. I gotta get her a power fist. I'm sorry, dear. I'm terribly sorry. You wait here, and I'll be right back.
Could have brought something to read.
So here's what we were up to. We could remove Jackson, so to speak, without anybody being any the wiser, or we could simply clear the roads in Jackson for a Mojave Outpost HQ. And I think that is what we're going to work on. We've got to clear the roads, which means we are going to... Wow. Okay, yeah, we're going to the outpost. Which makes me just all that much happier that we have... I know it was in there somewhere. Mojave Outpost. So glad we have this truck. Okay, everybody is here. We're here at this outpost. And we've got to apparently talk to Jackson. Find empty. Are there any more of those? I don't know. I'm willing to bet I'll find Jackson in here, though. There we are. Excuse me. You look... Yeah, Ranger Jackson.
Looks like we got a new visitor in the old Brahmin pen. Not many people coming here in a hurry. Only passing through. And if you're passing through, you picked a bad time. Road north has gone to hell, and if I let a caravan through, they won't make it.
Well, that sucks. You seem like you have enough shoulders and soldiers.
Soldiers, no. Recruits, yes. And the Mojave Outpost has been ordered to have a standing force at the NCR perimeter at all times. So sending anyone out reduces the outpost's numbers and would be in direct violation of my orders from back west.
Was the NCR sending anybody new?
Sending more troops, yes. To reinforce the outpost, no. Troops head through here on their way to McCarran, or to the front lines at Forlorn Hope. Or they're on leave, on their way to New Vegas to piss away their pay. All of them, passing through.
Great, you sound really frustrated.
Frustrated? No, I have my orders. Signed and approved all the way up the chain from Kimball. And I understand the reasons. The outpost isn't a Legion target, yet. Not like Vegas or the Dam. But if the caravans get choked here, that's gonna bite NCR hard. Anyway, didn't mean to talk your ear off. Some days, just feel like more requisition forms and daily reports come across my desk than results.
I know the feeling, trust me, man. Any way I can help?
Help? Now look, I appreciate... you know what? Yes, I could use the help. You look like you can handle yourself. I need to get the caravans moving again. That means clearing a path north. There's too much crawling the asphalt up the road to allow it.
Okay. Yeah, sounds like a deal.
Thanks, I appreciate it. Come back here when you're done. I might accidentally lose some supplies to pay you with.
Hey, thanks. By the way...
We won't go quietly. The Legion can count on that.
Those glasses kind of heart-shaped? I don't know. Alrighty. Come on, boys and, well, girl and Spaceball. We now have to head north. We now have to head... Oh, it's like right here. Just this way? Right. Wait a minute. Am I confused on my questesis? I am. Clear the roads for you. Jackson was the one we took. Okay, this is where we need to go. And that is... Okay. Oh, just at the end of the road. Alrighty, that's easy enough. Let's go, guys. You ever notice you can't run backwards in this game? Slow down instead. That's annoying. See, and as cool as my truck is, part of me would love to have one of... No, never mind. I'm happy with my truck. I am happy. It took almost an entire episode to get that thing. Good. We have vehicle. And while I'm down here, I may as well run over to Prim and see if we can't find Johnson Nash. I think he might have something to tell me, if nothing else. Also, I've got to, we've kind of lost sight of the hunt for Benny. You just taking a break? Alrighty. Oops. Let's see here. That's right, I kinda, sorta... I wanna take a look. Using this. Boop. Where's the 45 auto there? Medicine stick will be there. Paciencia, actually. I want that there, and I want that there. You know what I forgot? My binoculars and mines and stuff. I forgot to reload all that stuff up. So, alrighty. I guess we'll deal for now. Silencer for it. Okay. Sorry, just doing a little investigation here. Now, have we got any creepy crawlies? Yes, we do. Really? There we are. I don't know why I'm sniping bugs. I guess I just feel like it. That is impressive when they kill with that energy weapon, isn't it? And there we are. Oh, you. There, got him before he went behind. This is the Paciencia rifle that I wanted to give a shot to anyhow. And we haven't quite gotten an all clear on our quest, so I'm guessing... There we are. Completed. Clear out the critters. We are clear of critters. And so we shall go back, and I shall spare you the trip, for it is a boring one. Okay. Back in we go.
Ranger, we won't go quietly.
Yeah. Ranger Jackson. Who is... Right there.
Appreciate the help.
You're welcome.
Wish I had more work for you, but nothing else on the radar at the moment.
Okay. You mentioned a reward.
No, I mentioned you might accidentally get supplied, and I meant it. Not allowed to contract mercenaries at the outpost.
Okay.
Still, a requisition form or two can get lost, and they're not gonna come check. So here you go. Just between us.
Service rifle. Why, thank you.
Appreciate the help. Wish I had more...
Oh, you said that. Never mind, I'll be going now.
Take care. Cool your heels over in the barracks if you want.
Okay.
Hey.
Hey. Alrighty, so now... I don't need to remove Jackson, so to speak. I cleared the road for him. So now all of our caravans should be free, and we shouldn't have to do anything else to get Cass on our side, and she can travel. God! She can travel with us.
You come around like a bad habit.
Yeah. Helped out Jackson, cleared the road north.
Guess that settles that then.
Yep.
Give me that paper.
You got it.
I'll put my name to it.
Thank you.
No sense trying to hold the past between your fingers when it's nothing but dirt. All right. There you go. Caravan's yours. Feel kind of relieved, actually. Guess I didn't realize how much I was carrying around with just the name.
I understand. I really do. And, what are you gonna do now?
No idea. Maybe... head back west? Though the idea of heading back
there with
my tail between my legs isn't appealing.
You could come with me, yes.
Go with you?
Yes.
And why the hell would I do that?
Because I'm awesome. Why not? You could... I could use someone who knows the roads, that's right.
So you're looking for someone to help, not just tag along.
Yeah.
Huh. Walking the Mojave with you can't be any worse than here, that's for sure. All right. I'm in.
Good girl. Alrighty. I have the whiskey rose, Burke, and I am going...
All this traveling's making me thirsty.
Did I just steal something accidentally? Was I so damn good that even I didn't notice? Because I heard the bad karma sound. I'm confused. All right, let's go. And we have everybody. Okay. I guess the question is, now what? Crimson Caravan coming down. Okay, so we have a little bit more work to do for Miss McLafferty. I hope you don't mind, Cass. It's a thing. So that's where we're going to head now, is we're going to give Alice McLafferty the good... Actually, no. We're going to head to Gunrunners, and I'm going to give my stealthiness a try. Alright, Cass? Are you going to be okay coming in here? I mean, these are the... Never mind, we're at the Gunrunners. But... Just gonna head up here. Head over here. And everybody... Yeah, everybody wait here. And while I'm here, I know something I want to...
Let's roll out, then.
Standing around was getting exciting.
Come on. There you go. You can be my distraction girls. Veronica? Okay, why are you standing in the bush? Okay. Everybody come over here.
Good. My fists were getting bored. Line the bottles up. I'm ready.
They'll never see the haymakers coming. No, sorry, I get distracted. Been scavenging too long.
Okay, all right, fine. Everybody...
I'll hold up here. Don't be long.
Oh, you. That's right. Don't lose the truck, Scott. We're going to use the gun runners are always freaking loaded, which is a happy thing, which means that we can get a chance to get rid of some of these. So, hi robot, got
Hello.
Something for you.
Welcome, sir or madam. Do you wish to purchase something?
What do you got?
I am ready to process our transaction.
And you no longer have any caps to give me, but that's okay. All right.
Come back and see us again soon.
I will. I promise. I am detected. Now I'm hidden. Alrighty, and now for the real check. Did I bring? Okay, hang on. Everybody just hang out for just a minute, because I think I need myself some stealthy boys. And I gotta remember where I put them. Kim. I think they're under 8, aren't they? Yeah, I'll take them all just to be sure. Okay. In the bush. And we'll activate that. All right. I'm just going by quest marker here. Nobody see anything. Gunrunner, because I don't have a whole lot. Okay. Vendortron naming. Seriously, can we stop calling the Vendortron a Vendortron? Let's give the thing a proper name, like Bob. We're not calling it Bob. We'll vote on it at the end of the week. Please, please, please come up with something decent. Camp McCarran, Order 172, Missile Launcher 7, Missiles 200. We'd like this order to be expedited. If possible, the situation the dam requires it. And persona non grata. One of the Crimson Caravan guards, identified as Robert Wilson, decided it would be funny to take a shot at our Vendortron. He's lucky he didn't get a 308 through his idiot skull. We're currently negotiating with McLafferty for reparations. But in the meantime, we need to update the Vendortron's recognition software to filter out all Crimson Caravan employees. We'll also need to pull some strings over at McCarran and get them temporarily barred from purchasing ammo there as well. So he's trying to get Crimson Caravan. Oh well, I don't care. Let's get out of here before that stealth boy runs out. Thank goodness for quest markers. I really don't want to go visible while I'm standing in here. Okay,
let's roll out then.
Let's go. I'm just going to come back here behind. I don't know how you're following me when I've got a stealth boy up. Hello, Eddie. I see you peeking out there. I'm just going to let the stealth boy run out for the moment. Wow, I had a lot more time on that thing than I thought I did. Okay. Come on now. Yep, still invisible. Okay, it's a loud noise. Be prepared. Oh, God, it gets me every time. I don't care. And we're back. Okay. We are going to the Crimson Caravan. Now, this is where I meant to say, Cass, are you going to be okay? Because these are the people that... Okay, come on, everybody. I've discovered my truck. That's good.
Hey.
Okay, hopefully Cass doesn't go insane in here or something. Oh my God. So all I'm doing is I'm cutting out the traveling through the Crimson Caravan, which is ultra bright for some reason. There's something up with my mods. I don't know what's going on. And I'm just traveling through, coming through here to Miss McLafferty. That's an awfully pretty platinum bar you've got there. Yes.
Welcome back.
Okay, I have the hun. I have the Gunrunner holotape.
I hear it's business as usual at the Gunrunners, as if nothing unusual happened.
excellent work.
You're welcome.
We'll be able to use the schematics you acquired to begin manufacturing our own weapons immediately.
Good.
We'll provide some to you at a discount.
Good. Okay. Cassidy has decided to sell.
Very good. On occasion, it's proven to be more profitable in the long run to simply buy out the competition. And this is one of those occasions.
Yes, you told me that last time I was here. And then you wanted me... Oh, yeah, you
it's
wanted me
pleasure.
To talk to Doofusface about... his job. But if you'll excuse me, I just need to use... Okay, just need to use... I know you had one around here somewhere. There it is, yes. Just needed to use the restroom for just a moment. It's not what I wanted to do, but I'll do it anyway. I'll take that too. And I'll take this. I'll exit. Because that's what I wanted. We'll unlock this. We'll take those. Take that, that. And a three shooter. No idea what a three shooter is, but we'll just meander on out this way. Okay, I'll see you on the other side of the ultra bright thing. And there we are. With over half a stealth boy left and... Don't worry, Cass. We got her. Trust me. Oh, we got her good. Okay. Oh, come on, everybody.
Let's hit the road.
Standing around was getting excited.
Now, speaking of which, where were we headed? Henry Jameson. Where will I find Mr. Jameson? Oh, up through Freeside. But, huh? Oh, we're here by my truck and we need to go this way. Come on.
Where else?
Okay. Freeside. I've heard of this place. We've been here a couple of times, actually. It's a pretty cool place. Okay, damn it. Okay, so while we were making our way through Freeside, the NCR stopped us and gave us a radio so we can call them when we need their help. And I shot a rat for a kid. And here we are. And this is the doofus that we need to convince to quit.
Shove off. You're making my luck turn bad.
Oh. I'm here to talk about ending your employment with the Crimson Caravan Company.
Fuck no. No matter what that old bitch McLafferty says, my dad said I could be in charge of the New Vegas branch. Besides, I got into a little money trouble with the Omertas. If I quit the Crimson Caravan, how am I supposed to get the money to gamble?
Okay, first off, you should see what I did to the last guy that was sitting in a chair that got mean with me. I would suggest you watch your language and be polite. So you don't have the Emeritus money yet? You know what? I'll just let him know about that.
What? No, wait. Look, I just need time. Don't rat me out to them. You want me to quit the Crimson Caravan? Fine, I quit. You can tell McLafferty that she won't see my face again.
Good boy. Good boy. See? It's the way it should always go. Nice and easy.
How's it going?
Hello, James Garrett.
Welcome to the Atomic Wrangler. What can I get you?
You can get me, yeah, I could use some help with my reputation in Freeside, I guess.
For the right caps, I might be able to put in a good word or let people know you're not such a bad guy. What do you have in mind?
I want people to like me.
All right. I can chat you up, but it's gonna cost you. I'm not risking my reputation around here for nothing.
All right, I'm, I've got the caps to spare. I can do it. I'm a damn beacon of morality here. People should be lining up to shake my hand.
Great. This is gonna require an epic tale of heroism. I've got it. I'll say you slew a nest of Deathclaws living in the sewers.
Yeah.
It was bloody work, but you waded through the pack like a man possessed.
You know what's amazing?
Just
I really did.
To make this clear, I can only spin a whopper this big once. There's only so much people will believe before they see through the bullshit.
Okay. Alrighty. I did slay a lot of Deathclaws. Do you have anything for sale?
Sure. Take a look. Thanks. Bye.
Actually, wait a minute. You,
Welcome back, friend. What can I get you?
How's business?
We ain't scraping to get by, if that's what you're asking.
Okay. Do you have any work that you need done?
We've got the basics covered, but now you mention it, we have had unusual requests from some of our wealthier customers. If you can recruit escorts to match these customers' proclivities, I'd be willing to pay you finder's fees.
You want me to find whores? Maybe later.
Come on back and see me if you change your mind.
Will do.
See ya.
I'm not really a good pimp.
You've done a Francine. Lot for Freeside, and it is much appreciated. Here's one on the house.
So you fell for your husband's bullshit, too. Yeah, not for now. All right, have
Later.
A good day. All right, I'll see you guys on the other side of the glaring, sun-drenched hell. Okay. Oh, you appear to have some things in your office go missing. Last time I was here, since then, it's none of my business.
Welcome back.
Crimson Caravan Company no longer has to worry about Henry Jameson.
Yes, I understand that he's decided to quit outright and not even ask for compensation. I'm a bit curious what exactly you said to him.
I can be damn
again,
persuasive.
Perhaps I'd rather not know. Thank you all the same. I'm very happy to be rid of that man.
Is there anything else you need me to do?
Something has actually come up. A prospector recently came through here and spent a lot of caps on supplies. Closer inspection of these caps has revealed them to be brand new. This is a problem. The most likely source of these new caps is the old sarsaparilla bottling plant. Go there, locate the bottle cap press, and disable it.
Okay, I do have some questions about this bottle cap currency.
What would you like to know?
Well, like, why? Well, that's pretty obvious, but, what makes bottle cap genuine?
Lots of little things. The paint on the label, the machining, the type of metal it's made from. I know there's counterfeit caps floating around, of course. Fortunately, they're very time-consuming to make, so the numbers are small.
Okay, are new bottle caps ever made?
Certainly. Bottle caps do wear out or get damaged. Some people even insist on using bottle caps in explosive devices for some reason.
Because they shred the hell out of everything.
We make it a point to scour pre-war bottling plants and recover or disable the bottle cap presses. Seems we missed one.
Okay, and why is this press a problem for you?
People have been counterfeiting bottle caps forever, but it's always been small scale. A bottle cap press is a whole other threat. We can't have anyone devaluing our currency by mass producing new bottle caps.
Alrighty, well let's
Alright. Is there anything else I can do for you?
No, I'll go take care
it's
of that
been a
for
pleasure.
You. Okay. You're not a big fan, but hang on. Trust me, I think we've got, So we are headed towards the, bottling facility over here. This side strip, okay. Alrighty, everybody. You're gonna like this place. It's goofy as can be. Alrighty. Well, let's see here. Oh, and last time we came through, we learned about the star bottle caps and all of that. I just happen to have these here. Told you. It's the story that matters to me. Hearing stuff bang around. Okay. Well, there's Festus. Well, we gotta find this, and before we talk to him, we gotta find this bottling. Press.
Keeping quiet.
Now, we did some pretty decent damage the last time we came through here. Okay, not where I wanted to go. I gotta find this floor. You would think it would be just right behind the offices, or right behind the entrance. Last time I came through here, I killed a bunch of robots. So I'm not too worried. Aha. This looks like a capping press. Or a place to do bottling, at least. Now. Great. Upstairs, maybe? Maybe this is the shipping department and they just come through and so where we would need to go would be on the other side of this wall. You have been rocking back and forth since I was last here, aren't you? Okay. Council gathering. Whatever that is, it's out of order. Okay. Oh, crap. Oh, okay. Nice. Whew. Oh, now where would this press be? See? Okay, so it's got to be through there somehow. Can't Spaceball just go through the machinery? Can't be that hard. So it's got to be this, okay. It's this, yeah, this is the different floor. Yeah, because here's where, okay. You guys are loud. cap press if I were you. One saved message and one saved draft. I'll apologize up front if there are any. Okay. Alrighty, that's. Yeah, we read through those. Right. Oh, this thing. We will strip of all of its important looking bits. Alrighty. Completed. Disable. Return to McLafferty. Yay, but while we're here. That's quite the arrangement of stuff above us. This was considerably easier since I came through here earlier and just destroyed all the robots. Silly me. And I've already looted everything. Okay. Well, where was dear old Festus? There he is. In the Sunset Saloon. Festus, you're really creepy. Let me give you these.
Woohoo! You did it, partner! Bullet for you. Old Festus knew you could do it. I suppose you'll be wanting that prize now.
Yes, I do.
Well, then, hold on to your hat, because it's a doozy. Not many people have heard the true story behind Sunset Sarsaparilla.
Story.
Which right on her.
Story?
And now,
What?
Long ago,
People
didn't have a heap of choices when it came to soft drinks.
Oh.
It was either water or Nuka-Cola.
Both were good.
Now, the threat of legal action forces me to say that Nuka-Cola is a swell beverage, but sometimes people just wanted something different, you know?
Okay.
So one day, a man, a saloon owner in a small town, decided to make a new type of soft drink.
Okay.
And asked his patrons what flavor
you keep talking.
Like
I'm
going to
take a nap.
After getting no help from them, a stranger at the end of the bar suggested the man make a sarsaparilla flavored drink. The stranger said he would happily share his family's recipe for the drink on one condition. The condition being that the stranger would be allowed to sample a bottle whenever he liked, to ensure the recipe was being followed to the letter.
Sample the bottle. Yeah.
Thinking the drink would make him rich, and the stranger promised to meet him by sundown the next day.
This better not be my only prize. This is just constant yammering by a damn ventriloquist dummy.
Selling the new drink, and to this day, some bottles of some none.
Oh, God, it's not done yet.
Others say it's the stranger sampling the bottles like he promised. And that's the legend of the store. Hope you enjoyed it, and hope you continue enjoying Sunset Sarsaparilla.
Is this some kind of joke?
The Sunset Sarsaparilla Company has received a number of complaints regarding the prize awarded for handing in Sunset Sarsaparilla stars. Therefore, we have seen fit to provide another prize that we feel will placate the most discriminating customer. Just head through the double doors and follow the hallway to your left to the very end. An attendant will be there to present your prize directly. We at the Sunset Sarsaparilla Company would once again like to thank you for your patronage.
Okay. Oh. Oh, I never thought I was leaving. Okay, through the double doors and to the left, alrighty? Through the double doors and to the fuck you. God damn it. Maybe we can... No, that just leads out. No? We gotta get upstairs. That's the only way. There we go. Up we go. Alrighty. Now, is it down? Oh, I can't... Okay, alright, wait, I think we just went over the hallway, and so now, yeah, because this door wasn't open last time. It was here that... Deputy badge. Cheap little deputy badges. But I'm gonna take enough from my entire crew. More than I'll ever need. Broom? Broom. There we go. We've got some of these. I don't need any more than that. I can give everybody a star and have plenty left over. Is there anything else? Alan Marks. Yeah. Alright, I'll take your armor. Tape. And we'll take Pew Pew, which appears to be a valuable gun. Alrighty, what do we got here? Lockpick. If I get it up to 90, I can use magazines to get it up to 100, so I'll just have to start carrying some with me. What can I really work on here? Speech. It blows. I think we're just gonna dump it all into No? There we go. Yes. With light step, I don't set off enemy mines, which is a happy, happy, happy thing. And I think we've all seen that I have problems with that. Lots of problems with that. Is there anything else in here? Oh, some bottle caps. Okay, I'm not gonna gripe with some bottle caps. I wonder how many of these have bottle caps in them. Yeah, we're making out not too bad. Taking all these stars. Like I said, I can give them out to my crew. Oh, that's right. We got his holotape. Let's take a look at that. Miscellaneous. Buyout offer. Red. And his holotape.
I guess this is it. Not much air left now. Minutes, maybe. And this is what I have to show for it. I guess the joke's on me. Probably shouldn't have killed all those people. Probably should have stayed at home and taken care of my mom. She always used to say people who murder and steal die bad in the end. Said they...
There you go. Feel better now? Now, where the hell was I? Yep. Looks like I may have to go back the way I came. Hello. Hi. Apparently opened it last time I was... Hi, everybody. We're done. We're done. Let us get out of this utterly silly place. Realize it didn't do anything, but it felt good. Alrighty. Because I've actually collected all 50 of those caps on their own. It's not easy. And it's kind of a pain. Oh, that's right. We've got to get back to Alice. And let her know that the press is all taken care of.
Welcome back.
Okay, there you go. No longer a problem.
Good. I'm sure you were thorough. Here's your payment for a job well done.
Why, thank you. What do we got here? 500 bottle caps. You know what? I'm happy.
It's been a pleasure.
It's been a good time. We're apparently done with Crimson Caravan. Sorry. Seriously. Terribly sorry. Let's go. Okay, everybody. Let's get in the van.
Keeping quiet.
Okay, I'm going to pretend you're all in the van. And I'm just going to talk like this for a minute, because there is somewhere that we need to go. We've taken care of that. This right here, and that is not far from here at all, kind of through to the north gate of the strip. just on the other side of Gunrunners here. We go in. Now it's my turn.
You look new to Freeside, so here's a little advice, friend. Don't go past the Southgate greeter.
Why wouldn't I want to go past the greeter?
Those bots are programmed to vaporize anyone who enters the fenced-in area without authorization from the greeter.
Okay, well, thanks for the free advice.
Who are you? The name's Old Ben. I've been living in Freeside since the day I was born.
Well, thank you. Goodbye.
See ya.
I know his entire story. It doesn't take... Okay, so here goes... Homeless dude.
Exterminate.
Well, I guess they don't mess around.
Submit to a credit check, or present your passport before proceeding to the gate.
Okay.
Trespassers will be shot.
Not a problem. Credit check, what the heck is that for?
Admission to the strip requires an official passport, or proof that you're carrying the required minimum balance. These policies prevent less reputable persons from entering. And ensure a good time will be had by all who enter the strip.
Alrighty. Well, 2,000 caps, I got no problem with that. Science 80, 1C3C, R34M. Does that mean anything to you?
Thank you, sir. You may proceed.
Alrighty. So here we go. Onto the strip. And again, I'm sorry for the lighting. I can't figure out what the heck is... Oh, causing that. Oh, thank goodness. Oh, alrighty. Well, guys? Welcome to the strip.
Howdy, partner!
Whoop!
You've come for a piece, haven't you? Welcome to New Vegas.
I thought you were destroyed.
Do I look destroyed, partner? It's harder to put old Vic and Boot Hill than you might think. I wouldn't be much use stuck inside just one Securitron. No, if the one I'm in turns up a goner, I just find another. Fine as cream gravy.
That's a little creepy. What are you doing here, Victor?
Consider me your personal welcome wagon. Now hear this. The head honcho of New Vegas, Mr. House, is itching to make your acquaintance. Just head for the Lucky 38. It's the big old tower shaped like a roulette spinner.
All right. And why exactly is a robot passing on this information?
Well, now, it was Mr. House who made Securitrons like me. Seems the least I can do is pass on his message. Don't dawdle. He'll be waiting.
Going to have work with your commanding officer. He can keep waiting. But anyway. All right, guys. Welcome to the strip.
Your move, Green.
Thank you, Robotron. Look at that. We have Gamora. Which, while it's not exactly the cleanest place, it is pretty awesome with all the fire and everything. I mean, look at the sign. Wonder how they keep that much fire going. All day, every day. It's up there, too.
Hey there, friend. A bit of advice. You look like you could use some protection. Lucky for you, I got what you need.
Huh?
My stock in trade? All kinds of easy-to-hide weapons for slipping into and out of casinos. They won't give you a second glance.
Easy to hide?
Things guards can't spot when they're patting you down or checking for iron at your hip.
Yeah, I can get weapons past the guards, no problem.
You might. One fella I knew was able to slip a pistol past the guards. You? I'm guessing you could get a machine gun by them.
Probably. Well, let's see what you got anyway.
Take a look at these beauties.
What do we got here? We got a 22 revolver. Rounds. Yeah. Hollow point rounds, sure. and the Silenced 22 pistol. I'll use those to repair mine, and I don't mind giving you 155, you know, just in case. I'm good with that. Have a good day. Let me... repair that up. There's mine. Okay, so that's good. I'll hang on to those for repair. Turn these two kind of crappy blades into one good one. And, yeah. Eddie, come here. Come here. I'm just gonna put some stuff on you, just in case. Hold on to that for me, That one for me. And those. Actually, no. I'm going to take the good one back just in case I can sneak it past, okay? Alrighty. So there's the Lucky 38. That's the where Mr. House is waiting on us. And there. There's the one I'm interested in. Right on the other side of this gate, which hopefully will have proper lighting. And it did. Good. Yay. Okay.
It's hard to sleep in this place, I tell you. Last night, some girl was pounding on my door all night. Finally, I had to let her out. What? Hey, what about that suit Betty wears? If I had a suit like that, the ladies would be all over me. What? You expect a punchline? The guy pays my salary. It's... Hey, come on, pal. I'm trying to put on a show here. You're welcome.
Just a couple of questions.
All right, then...
Who are you?
The name's Knight. Billy Knight. And this here's what a lifelong career in comedy will get you. Oi!
Standing at a street corner in the middle of nowhere?
That's exactly my point, kid! Exactly my point!
And how long have you been doing comedy?
If you believe my mother, since she first laid eyes on me. First thing she said was, boy, that's a funny-looking kid. I guess I got a face only a mother could love, because no one else would give me the time of day. Hey, maybe you can help me. See, I can never tell when it's lunchtime.
So you're looking for a big break.
Break's better than a shot. Less chance of lead poisoning. Hey, if you know any gigs hiring, I'll work cheap. Real cheap. I'll take peanuts. I'll take the shells.
Goodbye.
Sure, later.
Please stop telling jokes. Okay. So... Benny is in the tops. I want to go pay him a visit.
Hey, fellow. Welcome to the Tops Hotel and Casino. I'm going to have to ask you to hand over any weapons you might be carrying.
Sure, here you go.
Smooth and easy, just the way I like it. Don't worry, they'll be as safe as kittens till you're ready to leave. Oh, and a friendly word of advice. If you happen to stumble across any weapons during your stay here, well, just don't wear them openly. You dig? Now that we got that little business out of the way, what can I do to make your Tops experience the Tops?
What's to do here?
Everything your little heart desires, that's what. You like gambling? Boom. Either one of the main hallways has cards, slots, you name it. Hungry? Thirsty? The restaurant just off the left-hand hallway has the best food and booze in Vegas. Or maybe you'd rather take in a show. The Aces Theater upstairs always has hot acts raring to go. Check it out.
Alrighty. Well, you obviously put them behind the counter there. Have a good day.
Have a good time, baby.
Yeah. I kept my Silenced pistol. I kept the sawed-off shotgun. I kept Pew Pew and the Power Fist. And the Switchblades. And the 45. And I kept all this stuff. Sweet. I'll take you. And, yeah. Wait a minute. Pew Pew. E-cell. Energy cells? Yeah, that'll work. Alright. Thanks, buddy. So, they'll take all my weapons away, but they'll let you keep your power fist and let you walk around in full power armor. You people are...
Ring-a-ding, baby.
Yeah. Okay. Now. Let's just check this place out for now. Upstairs. Ace's Theater. Oh, that's a familiar looking suit. Hi,
what,
Benny.
In the goddamn? Let's keep this in the groove, hey? Smooth moves like smooth little babies.
Uh-huh. Seems you need to work on your marksmanship there, buddy.
I hit what I was aiming for. Guess you had brains to spare. Or are you just thick-skulled?
I wouldn't be throwing
insults.
Either
way, baby, this is good news. Maybe I can finally sleep at night, knowing you didn't die. What say you and me cash out? Go somewhere that's more private-like. Any questions you got, I'll answer.
Give me one... I want the platinum chip, Benny.
I can't do that, baby, and you know it. There's a lot of angles to this caper. Complexities aplenty. But plenty of action, too. Enough for both of us. But we don't jabber about that out here in public. Like I said, we should be talking somewhere as private.
Give me one good reason not to kill you.
You want a reason? How about four? They're called bodyguards, and every one of them is packing. Me too, so baby makes five. Add to that, every chairman in this joint is armed, and not with some holdout pea shooter like maybe you smuggled through security. Anyhow, baby, you didn't come here for vengeance. You came to get clued in.
Yeah.
Like I said, we should be talking somewhere as private.
You'll answer my questions now, not
it
later.
It can't work like that, baby. Not out in public like this. You really need me to spell that out?
What'd you have in mind?
To start, I'll comp you the presidential. Best suite in the house. You deserve a taste of the VIP lifestyle. I'll hang out down here for a while to make everything look business as usual, then come to you. Any questions you got, I'll answer. Guaranteed.
No. Suite's in his touch, but someone's got to pay off my card. I'm not real worried about him giving me money. I am worried about him getting away. Yeah, lose the bodyguards and we both go to the suite.
If that's
now.
What it takes to win your trust, that's what it takes. Follow me.
Hello?
No sudden moves around the boss, got it?
Yeah.
Don't get too close to Mr. Benny.
Keep those hands where I can see him.
Uh-huh. Come on, everybody.
I got my eye on you.
Let's see here. What shall we use? Ooh.
Now that you and me's got some privacy, I gotta ask, how is it that you're still living?
Call it luck and last. Yeah, we'll just tell him the story. A Securitron dug me up, and the dock in Good Springs did the rest.
House was on to me from word go? I thought I was being so clever. Once you were vertical, how'd you track me down?
Seems you dropped something in Boulder City.
To think I deemed that flint box my lucky charm. Oh, the irony. I guess that's enough scratching around at first base. Tell me, which way is the wind gonna blow?
Yeah, I've got questions, a bunch of them.
You got questions? I got answers.
Don't ever say that again. I used to work for Radio Shack. First things first, tell me about the chip.
It's the house edge, baby. Literally. It's what Mr. House needs to stack the odds in his favor.
The chip belongs to me.
Baby, ease off the gas. The chip belongs in the hands of someone who can use it, as in me, not you. You'll get a piece of the action and a sweet one, but the chip sticks with me.
What's your offer?
You help me, and before long, the chairman will rule all of Vegas, dig? With enough robot muscle to back it up. You'll get a sweet, juicy cut of that action. But until that day comes, I'll keep you on retainer and pay bonuses for special missions.
I don't think so.
How's that sound?
Yeah, no deal. You're dying.
Guess I should have.
Let's.
Oh, that felt good. Oh, that felt so good. Oh, that felt good. Hang on. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Let me just... No, it's too good for the pool table. Let me just take this. Oh, this is morbid, but man. Oh, okay. Nope, lighting is no good there. What do you think, Veronica? Maybe we should just keep it on the bar. Yeah. Let me just shut that off. There we go. Oh, I feel so much better. Wine, crunchy, yeah, we'll have some food and a plate apparently I need, and yeah, fresh pear. You guys want some wine? Maybe I'll take some wine. All right, Benny, what'd you have on you? We had some 9mm. I'll take your suit, your sweet key. Maria, the platinum chip, and the presidential sweet key. Wait, that's two sweet keys. I think I ever paid attention to this wall safe anymore. Take you, I'll take you. Yeah, you'll do. Yep. Uh-huh. Yeah, we don't need that. Oh.
Holding my breath.
Oh, I think everybody's gonna try and kill us if we leave this room. I'm kind of worried about that. Honestly. Take the hat. No response from the intercom. I am really worried about leaving this room. because I've never quite done things this way before. I'm afraid I'm gonna walk out there and it's gonna be all over vodka, whiskey, wine. Ah, toy car. Go. What do we have in here? Stories. I don't think I've ever taken the time to, you know, go through this suite provided. You know, I've always tend to be running. I'll take the jet. You gotta admit, it's not a bad little suite, really, if you think about it. What do you got in your toolbox? Scrap metal and duct tape. Coffee pot. Carton of cigarettes. Chivalry. Bag of cigarettes. Bag of cigarettes. Can sell those. Yes, I'm delaying the inevitable. Whiskey. Thank you. And yeah, I don't need any of those. Empty. Fresh apple. All right, dear. Let's get that Whiskey Rose deal going. Great. I'm addicted. All right. Let's go.